This is Tom Bernacki, and today I'm talking about osteoporosis. We're gonna go over what it is, the tests, all the best home treatments, all the best supplements, all the things you need to be doing, and all the mistakes you're making. So stick around to the end and make sure you kick osteoporosis in the butt. Osteoporosis is a medical condition characterized by the weakening of the bones. The bones are made up of 75% minerals, calcium, calcium phosphate, magnesium, and about 25% collagen. Collagen is the soft, wavy, flexible part. Minerals make up 75%. That's that ceramic, hard, rock-like part. At age 25, we reach our peak bone density, and then it drops off a cliff. It's said that people over 65 or postmenopausal women, about 1/4 develop osteoporosis. According to recent statistics from the Osteoporosis Foundation, 1 in 3 women over the age of 50 and 1 in 5 men will experience osteoporotic fractures in their lifetime. 35 million people in the United States, weak bones, weak joints, weak muscles. This leads to a ton of problems. And this is referred to as the silent disease, because it progresses gradually without any signs until you develop significant bone problems that are very difficult to recover from. It is most common in the hip, spine, and wrists. Osteoporosis is usually asymptomatic until a fracture or joint pain develops, specifically lower back pain, wrist pain. I see it in the ankles, in the foot, stress fractures. If you have ball of the foot pain, heel pain, ankle pain, this could be an early stress fracture developing. Stress fractures in your spine can lead to loss of weight, back pain, hunched posture. Hip fractures can result in severe pain, immobility, the need for hip replacements. The primary cause of osteoporosis is bone remodeling. So you have 3 types of cells. Fibroblasts make up the collagen, so that's 25% of our bone. That's very important. And I go over it in a study about a new supplement called Coact, which can supplement the collagen, but most of the treatments we're gonna talk about focus on the mineral content as well. But essentially you have cells called osteoblasts. I like to think about them as blasting new bone. Osteoclasts eat the bone and put calcium back into your bloodstream. So osteoblasts build it up, osteoclasts break it down. A lot of medications like bisphosphonates target osteoclasts, so they stop it from chewing down the bone. But what we want to do is we want to build it up naturally and stop it from breaking down naturally. The biggest risk factors for osteoporosis include aging, hormonal changes, specifically postmenopausal women, and some of the treatments are actually estrogen replacement for menopause, low body weight, smoking, excessive alcohol, poor diet, long-term use of steroid medication, and deficiencies, so not enough sunlight, vitamin D, and a few other things. We're going to talk about those. And what kind of tests are there for osteoporosis? The most common one is called a DEXA scan, or bone density testing. This is the most common one. It uses values that are reported as a T-score, so it compares healthy people of age to essentially someone with osteoporosis. There's also other ones called the fracture risk assessment. There's blood tests that can check calcium, vitamin D levels, magnesium levels. There's also other tests like bone marker tests. I don't really get into those. Maybe the DEXA scan. I work with a great endocrinology group that does this. And if you're in the Michigan area, come get checked out by your favorite foot doctor right here. And I can set you up with the endocrinologist as well for some of this testing. And what's osteoporosis versus osteopenia? Osteoporosis on the test is basically really bad bone loss. Osteopenia is just somewhat bad bone loss. So obviously there's more osteopenia, and that's just determined on the tests. Let's go over the treatment. I don't prescribe these myself, but I work with a great endocrinology team in our office. They can do hormone replacement therapy. So there's studies for estrogen replacement. There's tests with monoclonal antibodies. These can prevent bone resorption. These are newer ones, and in the New England Journal of Medicine, they go over these monoclonal antibodies. These are very effective. Again, I don't prescribe these, but I see this prescribed. Calcitonin. This could be used to relieve bone pain, and this could treat fracture pain. A randomized controlled trial was done in 2018 where calcitonin had some good results. There's anabolic drugs. There's steroids that can essentially be used to build up the bone. These are the good steroids, not the glucocorticoids. And then the most common ones are bisphosphonates. Bisphosphonates like alendronate and risendronate, these can reduce bone reabsorption. They don't make the osteoblasts work harder, they make the osteoclasts work less hard. The bone breakdown cells don't work as well. These are not perfect medications. Studies show that this could cause a lot of side effects. Bisphosphonates long-term do have a lot of side effects. We're gonna go over more natural treatments. We're not gonna focus on the medications. We're gonna do a countdown. Number one, you want to eat proper nutrition and supplements. Specifically, the single most supplement and nutritional component is vitamin D. I could talk about this for half an hour, and I do. I talk about the vitamin D toxicity. The best vitamin D foods, the big mistake people are making with vitamin D. It is about 78% deficient. This is a study in 2023 that looked over the world with 8 million people. It's just as high as ever. Even with how popular vitamin D is, almost no one is getting enough vitamin D. We go over the risks, what people are doing wrong. Can we get enough from the sun? This is gonna blow your mind whether this is true or not. Can we get enough from diet, from the foods we eat? The results are gonna surprise you, so I highly recommend you watch that video. The recommended amounts are probably a lot lower than studies show we need. Vitamin D is probably the single most important thing, and vitamin D essentially takes calcium and puts it into your bloodstream. It helps your body retain it and prevent it from leaving the body. It's been said that if you take calcium supplements but not enough vitamin D, your calcium will just leave your body. Your body will not signal to retain it. But if you're getting enough vitamin D, you hardly need any calcium at all, and it will retain in your blood and go into your bone. Studies show that calcium and vitamin D together significantly reduce risks. This has been studied over a ton of studies. This is undeniable at this point. You also want to look at vitamin K2. So vitamin K2 is a newer one. I've made a lot of videos about this. Vitamin K2, there's no specific recommendations. It's different than vitamin K1. It's recommended to get about 120 to 200 micrograms in most studies. Vitamin K2 is very important to work with vitamin D. Generally, this is found in fermented foods and beans like natto, sausages, different types of meat. But as we eat more processed foods, we're mostly deficient in vitamin K2. Levels are lower than ever, and it stops that calcium from going into the bone. I go over the studies exactly what vitamin K2 does. Essentially, vitamin K2 takes that calcium from your blood into the bone, whereas vitamin D puts it into the bloodstream in the first place. So vitamin D gets it into the blood, and K2 gets it into the bone. Check out my video on vitamin K2 and all the recommendations and mistakes people are making. Magnesium. Magnesium is another huge one. Magnesium is in the bone, but it's also found in a lot of supplementary pathways. Specifically, the hormones that regulate high or low calcium levels require magnesium. The parathyroid hormone and parathyroid gland needs a high level of magnesium. And then magnesium is important to actually make vitamin D. You can't make vitamin D if you're severely deficient in magnesium. It's important in that pathway. And then it's involved in 600 other enzymes. So very important. 60%+ of people are deficient in magnesium. Check out that guide below on magnesium. And then omega-3 fatty acids. While it doesn't directly put the minerals into the bone, a lot of studies show that omega-3 levels, if supplemented, can gradually improve bone strength and quality and work well with vitamin D. And I go over a new supplement called CoAct. This is a collagen peptide formula combined with calcium that focuses on the fibroblasts that build the collagen in our bone. That's a newer one. It is not as proven as the other ones, but I go over that in a video linked below. And the single most important thing you want to do for your osteoporosis is strength train. You have to load your bones. This is the single most important thing. The British Journal of Medicine did a study within the last couple of years looking at mortality, and this involved bone strength. People who strength train, and this is simple stuff like doing Pilates, wall push-ups, air squats like this. I'm not saying going to lift heavy weights, but even going on walks qualifies as strength training. Anything that loads your joints with body weight, there's something called Wolf's Law. Wolf's Law says if you put pressure on a bone, that bone will strengthen. I talked about osteoblasts and osteoclasts. When you put weight on your bones, it stimulates those osteoblasts to work hard, to build new bone, and prevents that breakdown. Strength training is unbelievably important. And that means getting up, moving around. It's that easy. You don't need to do any secret remedies. It's getting enough nutrients to build up those calcium building blocks, that mineral matrix, making sure you get enough collagen in your diet. Make sure you get enough protein. Supplement with protein as well. That will strengthen your bones. And then you got to load those bones. So whether you're doing cardio or specifically strength training, that will get it better. If that still doesn't do it, check with an endocrinologist, get your DEXA scan, get your quality scanned, and look at specifics. Maybe you have osteoporosis because you're going through menopausal changes. Maybe you have hormonal changes. Maybe you're on steroids. You got to look at all these health conditions. Smoking, alcohol, you got to cut those things out. Correcting those issues will make a big, big difference. And you got to eat a proper diet. The more sugar you eat, the more processed foods you eat, the less of those nutrients you're going to get. So it's very important. Proper natural supplement through diet, proper diet, load those bones, get some cardio in. If that doesn't do it, then get checked out. But that should do it in the vast majority of people.